Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Waldia, and in today's video I am so excited and elated, not only because I get to show you my Valentine's Day makeup look, but also because I reached 5,000 subscribers, and I couldn't have done it, of course, without you guys. So as a token of my appreciation, I am doing a giveaway, y'all. Today is February 7th, so the giveaway starts today and it will end in exactly 1 week from today, which will be February 14th on Valentine's Day. This will be my very first giveaway, and the giveaway prize will be a $100 gift card to Sephora. All right, so here are the rules. All you have to do is subscribe to my channel, number one. Follow me on Instagram. I will leave it here on the screen and also down in my description box. So after you subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram, just let me know in the comment section by just stating done. So feel free to write any comment that you want, but at the end of the comment, just write done so that I know that you're entering the giveaway. 5,000 subscribers, like I just can't, I never would have thought, I just can't. All right, anyway, I can go on and on and on and on. Y'all already know I can, okay? I can talk, okay? But I'm not gonna do that. All right, so if you guys wanna see how I achieve this makeup look for Valentine's Day with the lip gloss and the pink and the everything and the glow, just keep on watching. To start off, I'm gonna moisturize my face with Lancome Firming and Dark Spot Correcting Moisturizer. Y'all, I like this moisturizer because I have extremely oily skin, but this doesn't add any more oils to my face, and it does moisturize my face without making it oily, if that makes sense. And of course I have to smell it, and it smells amazing, and it has SPF 30, so you can't go wrong with this moisturizer. Right, I'm gonna take care of my brows off camera, and now I am just gonna use the Kat Von D Lock It Tattoo concealer just to conceal my eyes, just to make sure that it's primed and that I start off with a good base, and then I am going to set that with my Banana Ben Nye powder. Next, I'm gonna go in with Clarins Wet and Dry Smoothing and Long Lasting Eyeshadow Quad. It has 4 eyeshadows in this, and I'm just showing you guys the packaging. It gives you instructions just in case you're a beginner like myself, and I love this because the front part of it is like a mirror, okay? And this is a number 7. And these are the 4 colors that it comes in. I'm gonna try to use most of these colors, but I know for sure I'm gonna use that mauve color and the dark color. Next, I'm gonna take a transition color from my Deco Scarlet palette. You could use any transition color that you want. And then I am going to apply that dark color from that eyeshadow palette to the outer V of my eye, and I'm gonna drag it more towards the center. Then I'm gonna take that color, and it's like a mauve-y, pinky color, but it wasn't as bright as I thought it was gonna be. I wanted this look to be more pinky. So I'm gonna take this pink shade from my Morphe 35B palette and layer that on top of that mauve-y color. Now I'm just gonna go with a fluffy brush and just blend it, making sure that there are no harsh lines, okay? Next, I'm gonna take that light color from the quad, and I'm gonna use this brush that it came with, and I'm gonna use it as my eyebrow highlight color, and then go back and blend everything. Next, I'm gonna prime my face with Pores, Dr. Brand's Pores No More, and I'm gonna use the Estee Lauder foundation as my foundation. Now, I'm gonna use this sponge that I received from Juno & Company. Now, it's their Juno Microfiber Sponge. And what I notice about this is that it does not soak up as much product and foundation like the original Beauty Blender does. So this sponge is really good, y'all. I am going to be using this more often. Next, I'm gonna be using some more brushes that I received from Juno & Company. I'm gonna use this one. This is the ES05 brush. I'm gonna use this brush to blend my contour. I will leave everything in the description box, all the brushes I'm using, especially from the Juno & Company brushes, because I'm really liking their brushes and they're super affordable. I'm just gonna blend, 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 making sure there are no harsh lines. And I'm gonna set my highlighted areas with my Laura Mercier Medium Deep Translucent Powder. gonna use this blush from Number 7 Company, and it's called Berry Crush. I love this as a blush because it's not too overpowering, and it's the perfect shade for my skin tone. So if you're my skin tone, or darker, or even a little lighter, I think you'll enjoy this blush. Next, I'm gonna tight line my eyes and also wing my eyeliner. Next, I'm gonna use this Extreme Longwear eyeliner that was sent to me by Lancome. And y'all, this eyeliner did not budge. I am going to apply it in the inner tear ducts, okay, in the beginning part of my bottom eyelash. And then I'm going to apply my mascara as usual. And I'm gonna be applying these eyelashes from Huda Beauty. It is the number 11 Sasha. Right, next it's time to apply the lippy. Gonna use my K lip liner and also NYX Suede liquid lipstick. I'll leave the shade in the description box. My favorite highlighter as of late has been the Artist Couture Jackie Ina collaboration in the color Le Bronze. Y'all, this highlighter is bomb on our skin tone. And then I'm gonna top everything else with this lip gloss from Fenty line. Guys, and that's it. This is my Valentine's final makeup look, the makeup beat. Please don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and also to enter the giveaway. Until next time, bye.